My name is Daniel. I'm from the Kokha in the Swaziland district. I consider myself privileged through my life experience to disagree with every white speaker that has spoken thus far today. I would like to start by saying that I do not join the modern day Van Riebeeks, who said to the chief of the men of men, "Where is your title deed?" I would like to say that if you have breath in your lungs, that is your title deed. If you have blood in your veins, that is your title deed. And also, your title is your title deed. Your ancestry is your title deed. And if it only goes to 1652, that is not far enough. And I say that as a person that's a sambudan on that ship with Andrea. We need to go to the original people of this country to take the lead. So I disagree with every black speaker that has been on this platform today. Having said that, I would like to say, and I quote from the Word of God, "Let God be found true, and though every man be found a liar." How can we take what is public and give it to a private individual? The Freedom Charter states, "The land belongs to all who live in it, not to the few who live in it, which is what we see today." Furthermore, I would like to say that the greatest agricultural civilization ever to exist did not exist with title deeds. In ancient Egypt, the longest continual agricultural civilization of 4,000 years, land was held in common and used for the common good. We have that practice in our country, but unlike other African countries, we are faced with land justice. We are the only country in this continent to have this issue. Why? We are out of step with the rest of the continent. I have been to Nigeria, I did not see a single landless person. I have been to Zimbabwe in 2000, seeing the people of Zimbabwe rise up to save land. I cannot fault them. Landlessness is unacceptable. We cannot have a few people stand here and speak as if they represent those that have been saved on the cross. I would also like to say that I support the version of process, making agriculture a compulsory subject for matriculants. I would like to go further and say that every matriculant be given the parcel of land. I would like to conclude by saying, and I support our government in its efforts to redress and to expand the economy through the expropriation of land and our population.